She heard you eat the hummus and the what we got you had there.
So, congruency is about dreams. And so many times our dreams are masks. Right? I had this beautiful calligraphy poem, and I don't know that I can read it through the mask, but but it's kind of funny because it said, if I could write a letter to you, Dan, what would it contain? Would it be filled with grief, sorrow, and pain? Would it be filled with bitter strife with no gain? Could I take the mask off of me with some paper and pen, revealing the deepest parts of my rebellion and my sin? Could I express to you what's really on my heart? To know that I've already shattered my own life, only for you to give me a new start. I can write this letter to you, God, and it is full of promise and glory. For I know you don't condemn me, but see me full of grace and glory. I write this letter to you, God, simply wanting to express how glad I am to be your son, your friend, your disciple. I'm writing to you, God, let all of heaven know I'm now your child. I've been set free to bloom like a rose. I'm writing to you, Jesus, simply wanting to express how thankful I am to be free at last. There's a couple of fish crackers on your table and some wine in a cup, as we know is grape juice. So I put two on there because Jesus sent them out two by two. And this is the redemptive side of taking the mask off.
Come on.
And God gave me something from Gideon's story in Judges 6 and 7. And I got so moved when I began to make the comparison about a man that had a dream because he had testimony hope inside of him. He didn't even know what his dream was, but he knew he'd heard the testimonies from before. And he's hiding. He's masked himself in a wine press threshing wheat. Oh my goodness. And I started thinking about it. His first task was to tear down the idols in his own father's house. Sometimes we think the task of fulfilling our dream is more than what we've been able to do, but it's not. It's really not. So I got to thinking about it, and Gideon's task then, after he tears down the idol, his task is to find an army, but he thinks it's an army to fight, but it wasn't an army to fight. It was great stewards to gather the spoil.
Come on.
As I began to study these 300, I began to think of one of the most precious people I've ever met in my life, Lindy Hale. And I began to think of Steve and his 300-person dream. And I thought to myself, what if this dream is meant to liberate all of God's children? Because so goes Atlanta, so goes the South.
Come on.
And the prophetic declarations have already been made. How hard is it to empower somebody else's dream? How hard is it to really allow God to give us a new start? You're going to have controversy. You're going to have strife. But guess what? Love will suffice. This is the lessons I've learned. I have been so liberated in so many ways from being established and connected with each one of you.
Amen.
I spend time on my face before God just praying and fasting and just loving each one of you before the Father. And the declarations that he gives me, I gave Lindy and Steve a word about Wales before they ever went there, about the tsunami wave of God's glory coming. And I want everybody to release the dreams of the hope of God that's inside of you. The way we do that is we take communion. So if you'll hold the fish.